This is the audio log of Counselor Elliot Swan, dated November 15, 2145. This entire research facility is in chaos. There's at least a 90% death rate among civilian personnel. Whatever Betrugger unleashed is literally consuming the base. People have been turned into some sort of undead creatures that are relentless. Campbell and I are making our way towards the communications facility. We must stop all communications. If a distress call leaves the base, then everyone here and on Earth is doomed. This is the audio log of Counselor Elliot Swan, dated November 16, 2145. Campbell and I were unable to reach the main portal in the Delta Complex, but that portal may be inconsequential to a more disturbing discovery. We have uncovered reference to another portal, created by the demons themselves, a passageway between Hell and Mars. We suspect it resides within the cavern somewhere near the archaeological dig. The fleet is on its way. Campbell and I will attempt to move there and somehow either shut it down or destroy it. That hellhole must be closed before the fleet arrives.
This is the audio log for Tony Bates, Mars Security IT Division, September 25th, 2145. I spent the last 4 hours going through the code for the door systems here in Central Processing. This is proving to be a real ditch of a glitch to work out. I've traced through every system I could think of, and access to Lab A continues to be problematic for the time being. All the regular access codes seem to be working fine, but the database will not allow access rights to be granted to new visitors. In the meantime, I'm adding a backdoor code into the systems for IT staff and the eggheads, so if they need access to Lab A while the systems are on the bridge, they can use the code 627 to bypass door security. End of line. This is the audio log for Tony Bates, Mars Security IT Division, October 15th, 2145. I resumed my investigation into case A-10982, the systems intrusion that took place in the CPU complex yesterday. All network traces seem to originate from an old system located in Site 2, Office S2-038. What is truly troubling is that engineering informs me electrical systems have been offline in that section for years, and were only reactivated this morning in order to prepare more storage space. I'm completely stumped on this. How does a hack originate from a section of the base that has been out of commission for so long? I will make another report once I personally investigated the suspect office in Site 2. End of log.
This is the audio log of Charlie Haskell, Delta Labs technician, dated September 23rd, 2145. We're making good progress in increasing the max range of Chamber 3 in the Delta complex. We've been crunching numbers all night and feel that with a few slight modifications, we should be able to boost output to cover all of Delta. The latest schedule changes are wreaking havoc on our current systems, and it's not uncommon to see system utilization of 99% of the days of time. We understand that Lab A has finally received the NREC 6809 system. Please consider this a formal request for a block of 2 hours to run our latest formulas at the soonest available time.
Thank you. I killed that pathetic bodyguard, and now I will kill you. Thank you. I look into your soul, and I see fear.
In motion. Destination. Thank you.
Research and design. The BFG 9000 is the most advanced firearm ever designed. Fully self-contained and deployed as a handheld platform, it is capable of an excessive amount of firepower. The BFG 9000 contains sophisticated friend or foe technology that discriminates targets in real time. Each projectile contains a small but very powerful computer core that actively maintains targeting and delivers a stream charge down each beam to soften targets before detonation. The detonation stage of the projectile is devastating. Targets within 15 meters of the flashpoint are not likely to survive. While not recommended for small quarter combat, the BFG 9000 is ideal in the field and against multiple targets. The only foreseeable defense is small arms ballistics. If the projectile is destroyed before exploding, the computer core cannot process the final fusion reaction, resulting in a less than optimal detonation. For more information, contact the UAC's Advanced Weapons Department.
Security clearance accepted.